Hi guys, welcome to VFX Rendering. In this video, VFX Rendering will start a small project created in Cinema 4D and Redshift Render. The project has 8 frames and a 1920 by 1080 resolution. We use Cinema 4D R26 and Redshift 3.5 and 0.10. Okay, let's move to the part we've all been waiting for today. We will conduct the test on the 5 best render farms: Fox Render Farm, GarageFarm, iRender Farm, Ranch Computing, and RebusFarm. Each render farm has a few render tiers. We have to think a bit about which tier to choose. On render farms offer priority including GarageFarm, Ranch Computing, and RebusFarm, we will test the standard priority, aka low priority. Fox Render Farm and iRender don't have priority. So we decide to choose the GPU 3090 node of GPU Region 1 on Fox Render Farm, and the 8 GPU 3090 package of iRender Farm. The test was done on December 7th and 8th of 2022. The first render farm is Fox Render Farm. Their workflow consists of 4 steps: uploading scenes and assets, submitting a job, analyzing scenes, and rendering. You can upload and manage the projects through web submission and desktop clients. We use web submission. Fox offers Raysync for users to upload and download projects at high speed when uploading the files. After uploading, you move to new job, select Cinema 4D and the render file, and continue. At this step, you will configure the software version and hardware. For render software, we select C4D R26 and Redshift 3rd of May 10. For hardware, we choose GPU 3090. The default and only option for GPU number R2. The price for GPU rendering at Fox is also based on 2 GPU nodes. The next step is to go through the analysis. The farm will analyze your scenes to check if there is any error. This time, the analysis takes us almost 8 minutes. Now let's render. You set the scene and render settings. One tip for rendering on Fox: you should test some frames and check the rendered images before going into the full project. Usually, we check 1 first frame, 1 middle frame, and 1 last frame. But you can test a particular frame you want. Click submit and wait for your scenes to start rendering. It might take a while. When the test frames are done, we decide to go full speed rendering because they are all correct. Don't forget you can see the preview of the rendered frames. Now the rendering is finished. Let's see the details. The total render time of all frames is 17 minutes and 25 seconds. But Fox renders many frames at the same time, so the time to completion we experience in fact is about 10 minutes. The total expense is $1.16. GarageFarm is the second render farm for testing. You will need to download and install their plugin, RenderBeamer. Then it will integrate into your Cinema 4D. Whenever you have a project that needs rendering, you send it right from the software interface and there's no need to come to their website. It's very convenient. Click RenderBeamer inside C4D to upload the scenes to the farm. After successfully uploading, you click the link to submit the jobs. It will navigate you to the web manager. Now you need to configure render settings. There are 3 priorities: low, medium, and high. As mentioned in the beginning, we choose low priority. You can also see that the GPU nodes of GarageFarm are 4XB100 and 8XB100, and there are also 8XK80 nodes. Submit and the job is ready to render. Do you notice there is a farm queue? GarageFarm lets you know how many jobs, and frames, are waiting to render at the moment. Tip: if you are in queue for too long, you can change the priority to push your job forward. Let's see the result. Garage renders are seen in about 7 minutes and costs 53 cents. Next, we come to iRenderFarm. iRender is quite different from the 4 other render farms in this video. You will rent their powerful servers and work directly on them via remote desktop. To put it simply, you have a second workstation. So you will need to install the software and use your own licenses. It takes us more than 10 minutes to install C4D Redshift for the first time. And don't worry, you don't have to do this step every time you use their service. The instance including your applications and data is saved after each use. For uploading files, we use iRender Drive, their app for transferring data. Or you upload to other storage services such as Google Drive, Dropbox, and more. As you will work on their servers later. When creating an instance, they call it an image, there are a bunch of packages for you to choose. 1, 2, 4, 6, and 8 GPU RTX 3090. The thing that makes me excited is that this farm has RTX 4090, the latest flagship GPU of NVIDIA. But we may try this package later. For this project, we use GPU Server 9, which has 8 GPU RTX 3090. After connecting the remote desktop and setting up the software, it's time to render. Just do it like you are using your computer. You could see the render process in real time. Each frame renders in around 30 seconds. So this scene renders in 3 minutes and 54 seconds in total and costs $1.82. This expense does not include the installation time. The next render farm is Ranch Computing. You will download and install their plugin called INC Hacker. It will be then integrated into your Cinema 4D. The INC Hacker plugin will check your scene if there is any error before uploading via INC Sync. Or you could send it via web submission as we are doing right now. Choose Cinema 4D R26 Redshift Render. There are 4 priorities at Ranch. We go with GPU Low 1. Then upload the project. Please note that the file must have the .vuc extension. After successfully uploading, Ranch will validate the project and send it to the rendering queue immediately. Same as GarageFarm, Ranch Computing shows how many projects are currently being queued or rendered. So if you are in queue for quite a long time, you always can increase its priority level so your project gets rendered sooner. The render time is 2 minutes 26 seconds. It costs us 4.16 render points, which equals to €4.16. The last render farm in this video is RebusFarm. You need to download and install their plugin called RebusDrop. The plugin will then be added to your Cinema 4D. After that, you can just send the scenes right from your application interface. The plugin will prepare your scene and upload it to the render farm, including all your assets and render settings. I think Rebus has the most priorities for you to choose from among render farms. There are 8 priorities at Rebus. We use the standard tier. When sending the project to the farm, the plugin will check first to ensure everything is correct. Next, you go to Web Manager to manage the render process. You can see a preview window for completed frames and the upload is in progress. RebusFarm renders the scene in 4.79 minutes and costs us 2.08 render points or €2.08. So, we have tested an 8-frame project with C4D and Redshift on 5 render farms. Here are the results. Fox render farm, total cost, $1.16, render time, 10 minutes. GarageFarm, total cost, 53 cents, render time, 7 minutes. iRender Farm, total cost, $1.82, render time, 3 minutes and 54 seconds. Ranch Computing, total cost, €4.16, render time, 2 minutes and 26 seconds. Rebus Farm, total cost, €2.08, render time, 4 minutes and 37 seconds. The results above show that GarageFarm is the cheapest render farm, and Ranch Computing is the fastest render farm. An iRender farm should be the choice for the balance between speed and price. That's all about today. Hope you will find a suitable render farm for C4D Redshift based on our test results. We will continue making more render farm comparison videos. Please comment below if you want us to make a video for any software. And don't forget to subscribe and like if you like our videos. See you next time.